In Ukrainian calendars, this winter marks not only the 100th anniversary of the proclamation of Ukraine's independence, but also 100th anniversary of Battle of Krude, as well as first Bolshevik occupation of Kyiv. In remembering events such as this, we are looking back and trying to understand the reasons of the failure of the Ukrainian revolution, more precisely the conflict or contradiction between the nationalist issues and Bolshevik issues. And I would argue that Volodymyr Vynnychenko could serve as one of the best examples of this contradiction. So to understand the tragedy, the drama of the Ukrainian Revolution means to understand Volodymyr Vynnychenko, who was one of the major heroes of this revolution. Political role of Vynnychenko during the Ukrainian Revolution, as well as his political writings, have been studied in numerous research. I've mentioned probably just Ivan Vysokolitsky and his brilliant essay about Volodymyr Vynnychenko in his political writings. I'm going to talk about a quite a bit different issue. I'm going to analyze Vynnychenko's literary works, and more precisely, the image of the Ukrainian Revolution in his literary works, as well as the contradiction between nationalist issues and Bolshevik issues in his literary writing. So here you can see all works Vynnychenko wrote during the Ukrainian Revolution, and I'm going to focus on three of them, which is Diary, Between Two Powers, and To the Outside. And I'm going to discuss several questions. So the first, what kind of narratives about the Ukrainian Revolution and mostly about the contradiction nationalist versus Bolshevik Vynnychenko created in his literary works. And the second one, which is the most interesting for me, what is the difference between Vynnychenko's political activity regarding the Bolsheviks and his writings about the Bolshevik? And how did Vynnychenko's understanding of revolution and Bolsheviks influence our common understanding of the Ukrainian Revolution? And the last one, finally, how Vynnychenko's anti-Bolshevik trend depicted in his literary works took the main position in the Ukrainian canonical version of the Ukrainian Revolution. And I'm going to start with the diary, mostly because Vynnychenko was the most honest with himself writing about the revolution in his diary, and he created actually several narratives about the revolution. But the ideological, I'm guessing the ideological took the main position, the main issue in his diary. This narration is about the conflict between the social and the national. This conflict, not new for Vynnychenko, this is actually the main issue, the main problem of Vynnychenko political activities from the very early beginning when he started to be a politician for all his political life, and also this is the main issue for discussion in his literary work. So just to explain what happened, I will start from the very beginning that Vynnychenko had a very strong, very sensitive feeling against social discrimination, probably starting from his age when he was a student in gymnasium. At the same time, Vynnychenko had a very strong feeling of being Ukrainian. I could mention just numerous examples to prove my idea. This is actually common things about Vynnychenko. I would like to draw your attention to a couple of things regarding the Ukrainian Revolution. Vynnychenko, when he depicted his mission of being going to provisional government to make negotiation, he survived and depicted in a very painful way because he realized Russian chauvinism. And he was much more shocked because the negotiation, the Russian Social Democrats, actually the followers of his party, also showed this Russian chauvinism, which shocked Vynnychenko and turned him to look back to Ukrainian national values. And depicting the everyday Russia, just how they're discussing the problems, and blah, 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 Vynnychenko talked a lot about the creation of nation. It's interesting because talking about philosophical and journalistic image of Ukraine, he is concerned about the creation of Ukrainian nation. So there's no doubt that Vynnychenko had a very strong feeling of being Ukrainian patriot. But it's completely paradoxically that the prevalence of national issues above the social issues, Vynnychenko regarded as a betrayal of the revolution. Because Vynnychenko's understanding of revolution was the revolution is social, which could be done on Ukrainian context. And that's why, you know, this is the main point of contradiction, and this point can explain the action, Vynnychenko's action during the Ukrainian Revolution. Actually, this contradiction between social and national turned to be tragic, and then Vynnychenko started to discuss Bolshevism. I would like to highlight that from the very, very beginning, I believe even in January or February, when Bolsheviks came occupy Ukraine and Kyiv in particular, Vynnychenko described Bolshevism as being completely total. He used the most negative characteristic for the Bolsheviks. But at the same time, being very ambitious, Vynnychenko was concerned by the success of Bolshevism in Ukraine. He asked himself why Ukrainian peasants didn't follow the Central Rada, but they followed the Bolshevik. And finally, thinking about this issue, Vynnychenko came to conclusion that Bolsheviks struggle against social discrimination, which is very close to his political thinking. This is the reason, this is one of the possible explanation why Vynnychenko, at the beginning, being completely aware, being completely realistic about Bolshevism as anti-Ukrainian movement, finally decided to join Bolsheviks. And this particular moment, that when Vynnychenko started to make negotiation with Bolsheviks, and he went to Kharkiv and Moscow, this particular moment is very painful, and here I would love to quote Vynnychenko himself, who describing the perception of Ukrainian history, he said that it should be read with Bramin, the same one I would use to describe Vynnychenko's writing during this particular period, because it was very painful for him to make this kind of decision to start to negotiate with the Bolsheviks. As we know, this negotiation ended up unsuccessfully for Vynnychenko because he was not included to Politburo, and he actually lost the chance to influence the politics against Ukraine, and he decided to put him to exile. So when diary discloses the role of Vynnychenko as a political leader, as a politician, literary works two plays between two powers and a play between two powers and novel to the other side give a different understanding of Vynnychenko as a writer who tried to be realistic and who tried to describe a Bolshevik. So in the first play, which was written in 1918, right after the Bolshevik occupation, Vynnychenko described the military fight between Bolsheviks and the followers of the Ukrainian Central Rada. It's interesting, Vynnychenko created actually two separate worlds, the world of Ukraine. Vynnychenko created generalized image of Ukraine. To give you understanding what is particularly interesting about the image of Ukraine in this play, I would like to use the principle of context. So in his previous play, which was written 1 year before 1954. In 1917, in this play called Mismara, Vynnychenko created the image of Ukraine as a territory with ethnographic peculiarities. So in the second play, which was written during the Ukrainian Revolution between two powers, he created a panoramic version of Ukraine, the panoramic picture of Ukraine. So if we use a different, the same principle, but in a wider context, I would like to mention that from very beginning, Vynnychenko tried to avoid a populist description of Ukraine, a sentimentalistic description of Ukraine, the Bolshevik, Shnik, and so on. And moreover, he started his writing career, his career as a writer, just struggling against this typical or traditional depiction of Ukraine. In this particular play, he actually uses a typical populist metaphor, a typical populist attempts to describe Ukraine, but mostly in interiors and portraits. But it's much more interesting to look at the image of Ukraine, actually spiritual Ukraine. It's much more important in Vynnychenko's image of Ukraine created in this play. So for a Ukrainian national-oriented protagonist, Ukraine's supposed to be native state, and it's repeated numerous times, and all protagonists, national-oriented protagonists, pronounce that a native state. It's very interesting, especially in the context of contemporary discussion about Ukrainian language, how Vynnychenko represented language in the process of creation, that spiritual image of Ukraine. Actually, the main conflict in the play starts as a conflict of language. Sofia, Ukrainian-born actress who made a great career in St. Petersburg, she returns home to create a new Ukraine, being inspired by Bolshevik ideas. And she believes that Bolsheviks could speak a Ukrainian with her. She's surprised that Ukrainian-born Bolshevik doesn't want to speak Ukrainian, and Russian-born Bolshevik just doesn't want to learn Ukrainian and to understand Ukrainian. So in this way, Vynnychenko created gave a characteristic of Bolsheviks as being completely aligned to the national issues. Moreover, I would like to highlight that the play is bilingual. Actually, this poem was highly criticized by Ukrainian critics as well as Ukrainian readers who didn't want to accept the necessity of Russian language in this play. But I believe this is the main artistic principle which was used by Vynnychenko to create two separate worlds, Bolshevik world, which completely Russian, the Russian language, and Ukrainian, the Ukrainian language. Moreover, the shifting between two languages could be explained as a Vynnychenko's attempt to create the specific world of existence. Because, for example, a Ukrainian gymnasium student would never turn to Russian, even looking forward to be there. Sofia, who is trying to negotiate the Bolshevik, switching to Russian language. And Sofia's brother, who is a follower of Bolshevik, when he speaks about Bolshevism, he speaks just in Russian language. So, the next point that Vynnychenko created, the spiritual image of Ukraine, is Ukrainian culture, which is represented in the image of Shevchenko. Vynnychenko described portraits of Shevchenko numerous times. Also, it's very interesting because Vynnychenko quoted Shevchenko numerous times. But the main portion of the play when Vynnychenko described the importance of Shevchenko is that Bolshevik destroyed the image of Shevchenko, which can be explained that as a main threat for the Ukrainian war. And the last point, this is traditional Ukrainian family, because Vynnychenko actually discusses the contradiction between the nationalist and national values, discussing the problem of family, which is divided by two ideologies. But I would like to emphasize, I find it's very interesting, despite the fact that the family is just crushed by the different ideologies trends, the image of family, the value of family remains the most important for each member. In contradiction, Vynnychenko created an image of Bolsheviks. Here you can see all characteristic, all words Vynnychenko used to depict Bolshevik. I would love also to emphasize that Vynnychenko created 13 images, personal images of Bolshevik, which is an incredible number. Moreover, each Bolshevik is supposed to embody one of the negative characteristics. So in the end, Vynnychenko created the image, terrifying image of Bolshevism as being completely terrible. But to understand this particular play, to understand Sofia, who is in Ukrainian literary studies, is recognized as a typical image of the Ukrainian Revolution. And to understand the play in general, we should look at one very interesting point. This is a coexistence of historicity and utopian thinking in this play. From the very beginning, I believe it's Yuri Boyko-Blahin who analyzed this play through the prism of historicity, claiming that this is the most historical literary work in Vynnychenko's heritage. And mostly everybody after Boyko-Blahin repeated this statement, and there is no reason to doubt this statement. I would love even to provide more information. I found incredible the Mykola Voronyi memoir. Actually, Mykola Voronyi went to the performance because between two powers, firstly, was staged before the publishing. So Mykola and the show was actually in the New Eve, 1918, and Mykola Voronyi went to this performance, and he stated afterwards that he was incredibly impressed because on the stage he could see the same terrible situation, the Ukraine under the Bolshevik occupation, that he experienced in the January of 1918. So there is no doubt to question the historicity of the play. But at the same time, Boyko-Blahin noted that there is something more than history in this play. There is something which is hidden somewhere, something which could be like symbolical meaning. And Evgenia Luhina picked up this idea, and she tried to look at the play from the prism of mythopoetics. And to put this play in the context of Vynnychenko's writing. And she realized that this play gives more information not only about the history of the Ukrainian Revolution, but also about the evolution of Vynnychenko's thinking. She explained niche between as a world of utopia in which Vynnychenko preferred to move, staying between two camps, between the Bolshevik and between the nationalists. So she Vynnychenko moved to utopian world, staying between, or I would love to say even above, or beyond. And a couple words about the next novel, which was written 1 year later, To the Other Side. And it's very interesting that this novel is about the same contradiction between the nationalist and between the Bolshevik. Vynnychenko depicted provincial city which is occupied by the Bolshevik. The plot is very simple. A pretty young lady is going to cross the border between Bolsheviks and between the followers of the Central Guarda, because she intended to kill the commander of Red Army. And old doctor who lost the orientation in life and who fell in love with her decided to join her. Very simple at the first sight. But Vynnychenko also discussed a lot about the occupation. He depicted Bolsheviks also following his attention attempt in the previous play, Bolshevik as a total error. And Heroi Kustuk, who wrote an incredibly interesting introduction to the publishing of this novel in 1970, he argued that this the road to the other side, this is the road to true Ukraine. Interpreting this novel as being completely patriotic and like patriotically intended. I wouldn't agree with this statement because if we compare this novel to the other side, the previous one, to between two powers, it became obvious that in this novel, the last novel written during the Ukrainian Revolution, this conflict between the national and between Bolsheviks turned to the merging because Vynnychenko discussing this plot using term adventure, melodramatic and philosophical, he actually talks loosely about the philosophy of life. In this way, Vynnychenko pushed away the Ukrainian Revolution as a historical meaning. So, talking about mostly about the philosophy of life, which can be used during any circumstances, even revolutionary. So, to summarize, I would say that Vynnychenko created a panoramic historical view of the revolution, mostly talking about the Bolshevik occupation. In his literary works, Vynnychenko created an impressive negative image of Bolsheviks, characterizing them as a total error. At the same time, Vynnychenko created an impressive image of Ukraine, and he created a lot of images of national-oriented protagonists who can be interpreted as a sympathetic view to the office nationalist values. But I would love to emphasize that discussing the conflict as a nationalist versus a Bolshevik, the author discloses his intention to stay between and above, stretching the tendency to move towards utopian and philosophical truths. And a couple words about the last point of my presentation, how Vynnychenko influenced our common understanding of the revolutionary events and mostly regarding Bolshevik and Bolshevik occupation. It's very interesting that Vynnychenko wrote actually three literary works during the revolution, Ukrainian revolution and the Belarus revolution, but between two powers, which is very controversial, as I tried to discuss. This particular play took the main position in the canon of our understanding of our narration about the Ukrainian revolution. So I believe that the anti-Bolshevik trend, which is highly discussed in Vynnychenko play, is much more suitable. It's much more fruitful for creating a narration about the Ukrainian revolution. And last point, just a little bit of humor to the end of our conference. Here you can see the poster of Yanko Filevich. The poster, which was a part of the very interesting exhibition, Prominent Ukrainians. And this poster about Vynnychenko, as you can see, and consists with several caricatures, just describing Vynnychenko biography. I would love to draw your attention to the right side, to the middle picture, when Vynnychenko is depicted, pretty similar to how Lenin was depicted in a lot of monuments, and this similarity gives a different understanding and more material to think about Vynnychenko and his role in the Ukrainian Revolution. Thank you.